I mean, I think it's gotten to the point where Demon Slayer, for a lot of folks, you know, it serves the same purpose that Cowboy Bebop used to, you know, in terms of like being a gateway for people who aren't into anime to experience the medium for the first time. Because it's not a genre, it's a medium. You know, every genre under the sun is contained within anime, but a lot of people think of it in terms of just, you know, Dragon Ball fighting shows or other stuff, you know, more fan service-y stuff. So, you know, I think it's really good that it's been able to kind of, you know, break down those barriers. And, you know, our culture is changing. I mean, you look at like, in the States we have Barnes & Noble, the bookstores. And when I was growing up, it was all superhero comics, and then manga was a little niche shelf off by itself. Now it's the opposite. Now the superheroes have a shelf or two, and then there's like an entire wall of manga. So things, you know, have really changed in a pretty cool way. But for the movie, though, yeah, I knew going in that it was going to be big. I didn't know how big, though. It was startling, shocking, really, especially when we beat Mortal Kombat at the box office. I think we're now, the highest grossing R-rated animated movie of all time. So I think what we beat was Seth Rogen's Sausage Party. So sorry, Seth. But yeah, that was a very surreal time for sure. And making the movie was really interesting because it was actually recorded entirely during lockdown. So everybody had to record from their homes. So these setups that we had used previously for auditions had to be upgraded, and you know, we had to transform them into real professional booths. And that took some doing, but in the end it was worth it. What's interesting is, with Demon Slayer, usually the villains have very tragic backstories, you know, where you understand that despite their monstrous actions, you know, they have their own unique motivations and they've oftentimes gone through terrible things. With Enmu, he doesn't really have the benefit of that. But what's nice, though, is, we've gotten kind of little snippets and crumbs of, you know, a backstory for him, but nothing that makes him sound very sympathetic. He was kind of a snake oil salesman in life, who purposely took advantage of the dying and the diseased. And, so he was, you know, not a good person in life either, and then became even worse, obviously, when he was a demon. But for me, though, what's important with Enmu is always to remember that, yes, it's very hard to sympathize with the idea of wanting to devour 200 people on board a train, but there's other parts of him, though, that you can sympathize with to a degree. We've all wanted that promotion at work. We've all wanted to, you know, impress somebody who we like. You know, and that's kind of, you have to find that sliver of commonality, because if you can't, then you're not playing a character at that point, you're playing a caricature. And so that's what I tried to do with him. And, I ended up getting really emotionally attached to him. You know, I wept, after our last recording session, because he is so wretched and pathetic there at the end, especially because he pretty much has to, with his dying words, he has to advertise the upper moons and how cool they are. I'm like, oh, that's adding insult to injury. But yes, yeah.
The film is packed with so many instantly iconic moments. I'm curious if you have particular favorite lines, either your own or other bits of that you just particularly love.
Let's see. Obviously for other characters, you know, Set Your Heart Ablaze is a pretty amazing, instantly iconic line for sure. And Mark Witten, who plays Rengoku, delivered it perfectly. But for me, though, I guess for Enmu, my favorite Enmu line would probably be, let's see. To die in the rapture of a dream, a blessing indeed. That's my favorite of his. But there were so many great lines of dialogue. I think it's part of the reason why the movie has endured like it has, because it has so many great iconic moments and memorable lines of dialogue. It's just, you know, it's stuck around for a reason.